So I'm a firm believer that there's such a thing as little L logic, which means there is like a rationale to it. And then there's a big L logic, which means there's a rationale to it. And as best as we can know, all things considered and factored in, it is the quote unquote right rationale. And right would be defined as whatever your objective is, it's going to get you to that objective in the most efficient way with the minimal friction, right? Minimal friction involved in it. That would be big L logical. You can possibly get to that objective another way, right? Maybe not quite as much. You don't hit it 100% or it takes you longer. There's more friction. That would still be logical, but it's little L, right? So there's a lot of different forms of that. I say all that because I believe I'm going to be somewhat provocative in this and a little bit declarative, but it's more to test it, not because I'm actually that confident, and you'll see what I mean. I believe the only way you can have big L logic, and it's not a guarantee, so it's necessary but not sufficient, is if you don't have certainty, right? Saying that another way, you have to genuinely entertain the possibility that it is the thing you don't want it to be or don't think it is. That's the only way you can actually test and know that it is the way it should be. Let me give an example that is probably somewhat controversial and provocative, but I think it illustrates the point. I was listening to some people talk, a podcast, I think, and they were talking about this topic of certainty and is it ever valuable to just be like resolute and certain and not second guess yourself? And the idea of Winston Churchill came up as kind of a counterexample to that, to say, well, he was really confident and certain in his approach and, you know, how to handle World War II, and he had a lot of, you know, resolve towards it, etc. Is that a counter argument to say that sometimes it's better to not doubt yourself and just go, you know? And one of the people said, like, well, I would never want him to, you know, doubt his handling of Hitler, right, and his approach to him, but the strategies in which you would get to that objective. And I understood the point that was being made, but I want to press it. I want to test it because it's more important to get to the truth and the right answer. In my world, the way I'm explaining it, the provocative, controversial statement would say, for Winston Churchill to ensure that he is most likely, right, increasing the odds as best he can that he is taking the big L logical approach to handle Hitler and World War II, the only way he can do that, right, and get that confidence, is if he genuinely entertained the possibility that what Hitler was doing was right. Now, the controversial part of that is, how the fuck could you dare say that there's anything about what Hitler did that was right? He murdered millions of Jewish people. He killed all sorts of people, right? Everything was horrible. Agreed. I do not disagree. And that's the point. I am almost certain that what he did was wrong. My goal, my objective, is to fix this thing that I think is wrong. For me to do that, for me to ensure that I'm being as open-minded and have as best clarity as I can as to what the right options are, I have to consider everything, because that's going to unlock things. That's going to give me insights that I won't get otherwise. If I close my mind to any of it, there's a chance I miss something. And at the end of the day, if somehow in some twisted, warped world, which I think we all reasonably agree it's not, there is some scenario where what Hitler's doing was right, the truth is the truth whether we admit it or not. So as weird and as uncomfortable and painful as it is to consider that approach, I think you have to take it. I think Winston Churchill in this scenario has to go and question himself and say, okay, let me entertain the possibility that what Hitler's doing is right. Almost certainly, you run that math for 5 minutes and you quickly come to a realization of like, I tried. I genuinely entertained it, but this is a fucking madman and he's doing horrible things, right? That's probably almost definitely, in this case, definitely where you're going to end up. The point is more about the exercise. Even in the most extreme example like Hitler, where it seems so obvious there is no reason to ever second guess that, what I'm saying is there is benefit to it. If the objective is to stop the violence, if the objective is to stop the madman, you have to genuinely entertain that what he's doing might make sense. And in doing that, you will likely realize it does not make sense, but it will open your mind to possibilities of how you should be handling this. It'll give you more clarity. It'll give you more open perspective. And likely, you will more likely find that big L logical approach. So in the Winston Churchill example, I think if you do that, if you say, let me get into this man's mind, let me genuinely try to understand how this could make sense to him and why it might be a good thing, right? That exercise, and you can only do it if it's genuine, right? If you do it superficially, you're not really getting in his mind. You have too many of those assumptions baked in that you're certain about that's going to limit you from really seeing it in his perspective. And perhaps really seeing it from his perspective allows you to better predict what he's going to do next, allows you to understand why he's doing what he's doing and a better way to counter it or to stop it. And that is the objective. So even though it's uncomfortable, even though it seems blasphemous to say, even in the example of Hitler, if you want to get to the objective, if you believe in your objective, and that's a whole topic in and of itself, that you have the right objective, but if you've done that work and you believe in that objective, you have to entertain the possibility that is the exact that it is the exact opposite of the thing you fear the most might be true. And only then can you have the confidence that you have the clarity to increase the chances that you'll find the big L logical approach. The frustrating thing is it still doesn't guarantee it, but I think it gives you the best odds.